This is another tutorial video of our digit management system. In this one, I'll explain a new feature we call dictionaries and how we use them to query relational database tables. Now, on the digit browser, there's a dictionaries tab. If you don't see that tab, you can go to settings, choose the profile, and enable that tab so you can see it in your browser. Here on the browser tabs, we have a number of dictionaries and the values that are associated with each one. A dictionary is basically just a set of values. So for example, I have a dictionary here called states, and in it I've got 50 state names. So if I just click on it, you'll see all the values. I can order them by ascending or descending order. You can see all the values. I can create a new one by just right-clicking over here and saying create a dictionary. We'll just call this test. And we won't import any data. We're just going to have an empty dictionary here. Now we can now go and add values to this dictionary. It'll prompt us. We say hello world goodbye. Now if we specify the same word twice, we'll just see it two times as a reference count. This just tells you how many times you added that word to the dictionary. When we're done, we can escape or hit the cancel button. And now we have a dictionary with three words in it, hello, goodbye, and world. Now we can also create these dictionaries from existing database tables. So here on our database tab, for example, I've got a little capitals table here with states, their abbreviations, their capitals. So I could come in here, so say I wanted to create a dictionary of state capitals. I simply come, right-click on the capitals, say show the values. I'm going to select them all. Now DC is not actually a state yet, so we'll take that one out of the list. And we're going to now create a dictionary from those selected values. And we'll call this state capitals. And that saved 50 values to that dictionary. So we come back to our dictionaries tab, you'll see state capitals, and here's our 50 state capital names. You can, just like every other thing, you can order them and see them. We could also export values to, so we'll do that with the abbreviation. So instead of creating them directly from a dictionary, we'll highlight them all. We will export them to a file. We'll do the values only. We'll just call those values.csv and we'll save them. So now, got to take DC out, but no biggie. Now we come back on our dictionaries tab and say we're going to create another dictionary. Let's call this ABC. But this time we're going to import the data. And we'll go out and find that values.csv, open it up, and now we have this ABC dictionary with the 51 abbreviations for, we don't want DC, I can just delete that guy out. And now we're down to just 50 abbreviations in there. So how do we use this to query relational databases? So here on our database tab, we have like a customers table here. And you'll see that, hey, we've got a state, we've got 2 million rows in this table and everyone has a state. But let's say we only wanted to include things from specific states. So here on our dictionaries tab, I took that states dictionary and I selected certain values. We can always do that. So I could select some values and say create a dictionary from just those selected. So I did that for the western states. So I took the 24 states that were west of the Mississippi and created a separate dictionary called western states. And I've got another one for eastern states. So back on our databases tab, let's say we wanted to create a query. So we're going to create a query. We want to find all our customers in the east. And we're going to create a filter. And we're going to say where the state, in this case, we're looking for states that are in the dictionary. So I put the in operator, and that enables these two buttons. So I can either come over here to the one on the right, click on it, and it'll give me a list of those dictionaries. So I can, let's see, where's this Eastern States? There it is. So now this will find every customer where the state is one of those 26 states in the dictionary. Now I could have typed them all in, you know, Alabama, comma, Mississippi, comma, Florida, etc. But in this case, we're just going to get them from the dictionary. So of our 2 million rows, slightly over half of them, 1,019,000, were in the Eastern states. And sure enough, if we come here and we say show the values, we should just see the 26 states that were east of the Mississippi. So we could do this with, you know, health information, with mortgage data, any kind of thing that where you have a large number of values that are in a specific set of values. You can use dictionaries to create those very quickly, and that will help do that. So with Chicago crimes, for example, here we have a 7.2 million row, and I created a dictionary here where I came to the primary types and exported out just the types that I considered to be violent, you know, battery, robbery, homicide, etc. So if we want to find all the violent crimes, so out of the 7.2 million crimes in Chicago, how many of them are violent? So I click on that. Sure enough, 2.5 million of them are considered violent. These include battery and homicides and all the different primary types that I specified. But yes, you can come in and you can create your own custom dictionaries and query the database based off those very, very fast. Thank you very much.